When Apple removed the headphone jack with the iPhone 7, they told us it took courage. And maybe they were right. Just like if you want to teach a man to swim, you throw him into the water, Apple did that to the wireless industry. And while they were learning to swim, they were selling them AirPods. Hey, how's it going? This is Pradeep. Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, please subscribe. Today we're talking about wireless Bluetooth headphones in India. Let's get started. Let's start by stating the obvious. There was no real reason for Apple to remove the headphone jack. It wasn't for more battery or water resistance. Android phones had been doing it before with all of these features. It was just that Apple hated wires and they wanted to move to a wireless future. Just like all the other kids who saw this one kid tearing its jeans, Apple created a trend and all of the other Android manufacturers ditched the headphone jack as well. Headphones and earphones are the two broad classifications of these accessories. Earphones are sort of wireless, truly wireless. They fit in your ear. Headphones fit on your head. They can either be over ear or on ear. Today, we're restricting the scope of this piece to wireless Bluetooth headphones in India. The first spec you want to keep in mind while buying these wireless headphones is active noise cancellation. Active noise cancellation basically uses microphones to listen to the noise coming into the headphones and then sends out reverse noise to cancel out those noises. If you're planning to buy a headphone, you're buying it because of good audio quality, and having bought that headphone, you want to be able to enjoy the music without noise. Therefore, I suggest that you buy active noise cancellation headphones. However, as soon as you add ANC to your search term, the price of the headphones immediately jacks up to about 10,000 rupees. The second spec that you want to consider is the codec. Codec is a language used by the phone to send data to the headphone. The better the codec, the better the language, the more amount of data that can be sent, and the better music experience. Basically, there is the standard Bluetooth connection, which is the worst quality. Then you have aptX, aptX HD, and LDAC. Most people can't tell the difference between aptX, aptX HD, and LDAC. So you should be good enough if you were going for aptX. Do not, however, go for standard Bluetooth connection. The third spec you want to consider is the Bluetooth version. Bluetooth 5.0 is the current generally available standard of Bluetooth. You also have Bluetooth 4.1, Bluetooth 4.2, and some headphones who are still rocking Bluetooth 4.0. Basically, Bluetooth 5.0 results in better range, better battery life, and better audio quality. So go for it. However, there are not a lot of headphones that have this as of now, so you would be better off choosing either Bluetooth 4.1 or Bluetooth 4.2. The final spec you want to consider is how your headphones charge. Basically, they either charge through micro USB or USB-C. USB-C is more efficient, is more widely available, and widely supported by a lot of devices today, including the latest iPad Pro. However, most headphones come with micro USB. I hate having to carry around more than one cable, but there you have it, this is where we are at. The Verge did a piece last year where they were talking about the state of Bluetooth wireless headphones and talking about how it was very fragmented. Having reviewed many of the headphones that came out at CES 2019, the piece still holds good. The Bluetooth wireless headphone market is incredibly fragmented in the world and even more so in India. Judging by what I just told you, you would think that the best headphone that you should go for is one that charges via USB-C, has aptX, Bluetooth 5.0, and active noise cancellation. But such a headphone doesn't really exist, at least not from any of the name brands. If you want to go for one of the Chinese brands, then yes, these do exist. But if you want to go for a Sony or a Bose, they do not. The best headphone that I can actually recommend in India today is a Sony WH-1000X-M3. Who comes up with these names? But however, that is in the price range of 30,000 rupees, so I think it's not tenable. The second best option that I can give you is either the Sony H900N or the Marshall Mid ANC if you can get a hold of one.